Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Rod, and today we're gonna talk about some grunge bands. When I was young, I used to play a video game called Road Rash. The soundtrack of this video game is absolutely fantastic.
I discovered bands like Hammerbox, Monster Magnet, Paw, Soundgarden, Swerve Driver, and Therapy. And years later, I searched for the history of the bands and I found out two amazing bands with underrated albums.
Let's start with Hammerbox.
Hammerbox was one of the few Seattle grunge bands fronted by a woman in the early 90s. Led by fiery vocalist Carrie Akery, Hammerbox equaled the untrammeled rage of their Emerald City peers, but also inserted a new wave energy in their typical Seattle blend of heavy metal and punk. Featuring bassist James Atkin, guitarist Harris Thurman, and drummer Dave Bosch, Hammerbox released two studio albums, one in 1991 with the same name as the band, and the other one in 1993 called Numb. That same year, the band also performed at Anfest in Bremerton, Washington, in front of more than 14 million fans to help promote the album. However, A&M Records didn't provide Numb with the support it needed, and it bombed. Hammerbox was then dropped by the label. Unfortunately, things went wrong, and they disbanded in 1994. Later that year, Carrie formed a band called Goodness, but was unsuccessful. Bassist James Atkins died in 2016 from esophageal cancer. He was 49. The songs Simple Passing and Trip are in the soundtrack of the game. In my opinion, the album Numb is one of the best grunge albums ever. Carrie Akery is one of the most hidden talents of all time. It's almost a crime that she never gotten her recognition. She has an incredible and powerful voice. Another underrated singer of an underrated band with an underrated album. Hammerbox, the pieces of a grunge soul.
Let's talk about Pawn.
Paw were considered part of the grunge scene in the early 90s. They are from Lawrence, Kansas, and the band's original lineup consisted of vocalist Mark Hennessy, guitarist Grant Fitch, bassist Charles Bryan, and drummer Peter Fitch. While they did not reach the mainstream like bands such as Nirvana, Stone Temple Pilots, Pearl Jam, and Soundgarden, they managed to gather a strong following and favorable reviews from the music press. Mark's voice ranges from a gravelly rasp to a melancholic roar chock full of emotional power that hits harder than Eddie Vedder's, in my opinion at least. Though often compared to previous bands, they actually don't sound much like any of them. Paw put out two melodic hard rock albums, Dragline in 1993, which contained hit singles like Jesse, Couldn't Know, and Sleeping Bag. In 1995, the band released their second album, Death to Traitors. Singles from the album include Hope I Die Tonight, Season Glow, Max's Silent, and the 5-track promotional EP Traitors and Covers. During this period, the band evolved by adding more instrumental and country elements to soften their hard rock edge. While the album received favorable reviews from the press, sales were less successful, and Paw was dropped by A&M in 1996, before their contract was fulfilled. The Fitch brothers formed the band Palomar and released the album World Without Horses in 1998. Paw still played together during this period and released the compilation of B-sides and rarities Keep the Last Bullet for Yourself on their own label, Outlaw Records. In 2000, founding members Mark Hennessy and Grant Fitch signed with Koch Records. The mini-album Home is a Strange Place was released in the same year with Jesse Larson on drums and Jason Magirovsky on bass. In 2008, they reunited for some shows in the US. In my opinion, the Dragline album is a grunge masterpiece. It is raw and emotional, The songs Jesse, Pansy and The Bridge are on the game's soundtrack.
And in 2018, vocalist Mark Hennessy performed live songs from Dragline with his new band, Godzillionaire. Mark is a self-proclaimed crazy about poetry, and in 2005 he released the book of poetry called Cue the Bedlam. Paw, the Heartland Grunge Band, Down by the Bridge. I hope you liked this video. Thanks for watching. See you next time.